Anne-Marie was one of the champion women swimmers of the legendary Jewish sports club, Hakoach Vienna. My intention was to reunite the team and take them to swim one more time together in the old swimming pool in Vienna. The 1920s were exciting times in world sports. Huge crowds gathered to watch baseball, soccer, tennis, and any kind of racing. In Vienna, over 500,000 spectators would gather around the banks of the Danube to see who would win the 7-kilometer All-Vienna Swimming Championship. For 12 consecutive years, two Hakoach swimmers dominated this competition. They were freestyler Fritzi Levy and breaststroker Heidi Bienenfeld. Heidi was one of the first female superstars in modern sports. She attracted many fans to swimming, young Jewish girls to Hakoach, admirers and lovers. In 1930, she married her trainer, Shigo Wertheimer, the head coach behind the success of the Hakoach swim team. But by the mid-1930s, Shigo was facing a major challenge. With the Berlin Olympics just a few years away, and Heidi and Fritzi reaching the end of their careers, he had to discover a new generation of Hakoach champions.
Young girls was round swimming, training, swimming, swimming, swimming. Then we went to Perchach for a month just to train. In the morning we had to swim 1,000 meters, 2,000 meters, only leg stroke. And in the afternoon, all the time with a stopper. And all was written down. And in the evening, Shigo went through the whole of Perchach to see that not one of the girls is dancing or going out or something, that they are all in bed.
The founders of Hakoach were a prominent dentist and a well-known operetta lyricist. They started out with an improvised soccer team that played against other neighborhoods. But within a decade, they captured the Austrian championship, and with a sensational 5-0 victory over the cup finalist, West Ham United, they became the first team to defeat an English team on English soil. In 1927, by now the pride of European Jewry, the team went on tour to America. East Coast club owners were so impressed by their soccer that they offered them contracts they could not refuse. 9 players out of the 11 stayed in America. This marked the end of the soccer team's heyday, but it was also the beginning of a new era.